Hi, creators. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica, and I am your guide to your creative journey. In this video tutorial, we're going to be covering more UV mapping, including how to UV map a concrete path as well as some rocks, and then transfer those to rocks. We don't need to UV map all 100 of them. We just need to UV map one. I'll show you how to do that in just a little bit. If you are new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out the creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in UV mapping this fantastical environment. All right, let's go ahead and UV map this one. Again, I'd like to try automatic because sometimes it does a really nice job. And because this is so flat, it's actually pretty good. When it comes to organic, though, it's actually not very good. And then we just start sewing. It's like Tetris, like trying to figure it out. Okay, so I might have to do separate pieces because this one might be better by itself, and this one, it starts to pull here. So we could potentially try to stitch it together. We'll see what it does when we unfold. Not too bad. I'm more worried about the top than I am about this particular side. So again, if you don't see it, you don't have to worry too much about it. I just don't like having, you know, floating faces. So this over here, which is overlapping, would be a really big no-no. But because no one's going to see it and my camera angle is facing this direction, then no one sees it. So I don't lose anything. But if there was a kind of like a camera fly through, or if this was like a video game that you import all these assets and the character can actually walk through it, then you would definitely have to take the time to stitch it. Now, I'm kind of like one of those people that can't not make sure everything looks good. I have to make sure everything looks good. So I am going to go ahead and sew it. But, you know, that's just me. Because maybe I'll put it in a game engine. I don't know. We'll see. Unfold. Oh, where'd it go? Okay, let's go ahead and start with this as well. Let's see. We have separate pieces. Whoa. Oh, that's beautiful. Let's hope Unfold's gonna fix this. Otherwise, I might have to undo. Let's see. Not too bad. This face here. Yeah, that's not pretty at all. There we go. All right, there's a couple of little gaps here. Let's go ahead and sew. I don't know. I've been having like Encanto in my head a lot. The Bruno, no, that one. And I was walking through my neighborhood and I could hear somebody blasting the same song. So I'm like, oh, it's not just me. All right, almost done with this particular part. Ooh, I got an Anagon. That's weird. Where is this thing? Wow. Okay, well, let's fix it. An easy fix too. Where is it? You can use the multi-cut and you can just go across and then here. And that will fix that. So we won't get any weird, unpredictable results. And the UVs already get laid out, so that's also really nice. Very weird, but an easy fix. Okay, get a couple more pieces. Let's see. Better. And where do you belong? Probably here. Yep. Is this the back? Oh, okay. Nobody cares. All right. Let's see. Stitch together. Okay, cool. So now that that's here, I can unfold again one last time and just double check to make sure there's nothing really big pulling. So, okay, let's talk about this. So sometimes when you try to unfold, it does a really good job on some cases, but sometimes it will ruin your UVs because you've got so many things going on here. And I wish I'd caught it a little bit earlier, but what I can try to do is try to unfold it by itself And we can try different types of, UVs to see if it works. But if it still acts crazy like it is right now, yeah, that looks weird. I'll just planar map it, because that's actually a very important piece. Whoops. Planar mapping options. Let me choose Y. There we go. And in the concept art, this is pretty important. So there's these things called hero pieces. Some companies call them god pieces, but in general, there's a focus, right? There's like you're looking at something specifically, and one of the big pieces is here. So we could potentially get away with UV mapping this to make sure that this actually has high res, because everything else is actually kind of like repeating. So what I can do is just separate it and make this basically the largest portion here versus everything else just gets stacked. So for example, I'm just going to move this one around here. See if I can fit it into the 0 to 1 space. And then for this one, you can just erase it because no one's going to see it. Unless, of course, your character goes underwater and then you'll see that whole, my character is not going to do that. Then I can just go ahead and delete it. And it also is going to help my render times. Now we have one piece that is basically ready to go. For these, automatic mapping should work relatively well. I'm not too worried about these. It's hard surface, so it's pretty fast. What I might do is cut these out. Let's say shift right click, and then I can stitch together each side. I'm just gonna click G, 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 and then G again. Now, again, this is basically the bottom, so no one's gonna see it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete it. Let's go ahead and planar map this one as well. Sorry, automatic. Stitch together, stitch together, stitch together, stitch together, stitch together, stitch together. Okay, one last one. Let's see, automatic mapping. Same story. Delete things you don't need. And then I'm going to make a cut. And then I'm going to sew. Oh. Stitch together, stitch together, stitch together. I'm just clicking the letter G on my keyboard. Okay. So the next question do you want to ask yourself is, do you want to put these pieces in the same UV space? Right. So it looks like all of these share the same concrete, and this shares darker concrete. So I'm going to just go ahead and assume that these are basically going to be using the same material, except this one gets like more space. There's two buttons I want to show you. One of them is known as Texal Density, and Texal Density just basically means that it will keep the UV scale the same for all of these objects. So that's going to be really helpful when we start doing the rocks, for example. You can find it under Transform, and what you do is click on Get, then click on Set. What it does is that it makes all these pieces the same exact density when it comes to the UV space. So now I can actually go in, and if I want to scale, I might want to scale all of them. So for example, I do want to scale because this isn't fitting. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of scale it in a little bit. Now there is a layout button that you can use, but I'd like to do it myself. Another thing that you might want to think about is doing what's called overlapping. If you think that this texture and this texture are basically the same, you can just overlap them. And then for this one, I'm just going to make it larger because I want the design to really be high quality and stand out. So when I export these, the UV map, I just want to make sure that you select all of these pieces. And this one gets its own for now. All right. So for the rocks, I'm actually going to do a planar map. And I know that doesn't seem right, but usually what I do is just planar map it, and then I grab an edge that goes all the way around. So let me isolate, select this one. So usually I just find an edge, this one. Let me turn off all this stuff because it's distracting. So I'm just going to go through and see if I can find an edge that kind of goes all the way around. relatively. Something like that. Let's go ahead and cut. Move that aside. All right. And then usually I just unfold and then unfold. Now, if you want to, you can go ahead and stitch everything together, but it can be a little bit challenging because it's kind of circular, but we can try it. So we can stitch together. Again, you can grab the faces, unfold, and then just kind of look around to see if that actually works out, and it kind of does. So I'm going to select one, shift select the other one, and then I'm going to go to mesh, transfer attributes. So you see how it actually transferred the UVs? So that's really good news for us. So I can transfer that one and just share the same one. So you select one, shift select the other one. It's under mesh, transfer attributes. Again, you just have to go to the options and you only need to select this component. I don't know why, but that works. So then, and then you just click on the letter G.
Okay.
Now, some of them are smaller and some of them are bigger. So we will have to do what's the Texal density. But in general, this will get the UV mapping started right away. So it's nice. By the way, the only thing I'm doing is deselecting and selecting and clicking on the letter G. There's one rock. I'm like, I know you're there. I see you. Right there it is. If your models are all basically the same, they share the same vertex information, then they should work just fine. So let me go ahead and delete all that. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Please share my videos. If you know of a 3D artist out there that wants to learn how to UV map, please share my UV mapping. I would love to help artists just like you. And don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you will find free resources such as ebooks, free 3D models, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial.